Hello, I'm Helen Bradley. Welcome to this video tutorial. In this tutorial, we're going to have a look at some advanced pattern fills using the scripting feature in Photoshop CS6 and Photoshop CC. Before we get started on this video, let's have a look and see what it is that we're trying to achieve. These are a couple of patterns that I created using a script that I found online. I'm going to show you where to get the script, how to install it, and how to use it. And it is a little bit complex to get set up, but once you see how it works, it is relatively easy and has some other tools that you can use just to make sense of what's happening. But this is the actual pattern that I have created, and this is another pattern using this same basic pattern that I designed and then dropping it into the image using one of these new scripts that is downloadable from the web. So now you have an idea as to what it is that we're aiming for. Let's have a look and see how we can get all of this to work. Now the place that you're going to get started is here. You need to type this address into a browser to download this zip file. And I'm going to give you that address in the description of this file. And when you do that, you'll get a file that is a zip file downloaded to your downloads folder, and you'll want to extract all the files in this particular folder. And these are the files that you get. Now the instructions that you want to use are in this wallpaper kit overview document. Now it's supposed to be a Word document, but actually it doesn't display particularly well in Word. So I'm going to help you a little bit with that, but you can open it because it does have some information in it. Now the next thing is fairly important as to where you put these things. So you want to pick up these shape files. So there's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of those shape files, and you want to copy those and you want to put them in a special folder. So let's just go and open a new Windows Explorer window, and I'm going to show you in Windows where you put it. So you're going to go to your C drive and you want to go to your program files. So I'm using Adobe Photoshop CS6 64-bit, so it's going to be in program files. If you're using a 32-bit, it will be in your program files x86 probably, but you're looking for the Adobe Photoshop CS6 folder. And you'll go to that and you'll go to presets. And inside the presets is a folder called Deco. And you'll want to open that and drop your shapes into there. So I have the shapes in there, but let's just close down some of these windows because I want to show you what else is going to go in there. Okay, so as well as the shapes, you'll also want to drop in these two JSX files, the specify wallpaper using several patterns and the partial plane symmetry fill JSX. So just drop those in that folder as well. Now, to make it a little bit easier to work, this is not in the instructions, but I found it works a bit better this way, is to wind back up to presets and go into scripts. And I also dropped the specify wallpaper using several patterns, this same JSX file, into here as well. So we've actually dropped it into two places. It works just fine in here as well. It's just a bit easier to find than it is in the Deco one, so I suggest that you do that. The last thing you need to do is to pull out these PSD files and just dump them somewhere where you know you can find them, because they're your templates, and you're going to see how they work in a minute. So once you've got everything installed, you want to close and reopen Photoshop. So let's just get rid of this and let's get started so that you can see what it is that you're going to do using that particular script. So I'm going to choose File and then Open, and I'm going to open the template file, one of these template files. Now the template that I am opening is for a 45 by 45 by 90 degree triangle, so I'll just click Open. To create your pattern, you're going to want to be seeing the layers. So I'll choose Window and then Layers. And what you'll see is that we've actually got an area here that we're going to work in, and we're just going to be creating a pattern in this top corner. Now there is a slight problem with this template. If you just pick up a color and just dump the paint into it, you'll see that you're missing the corners here. Something's gone wrong with the image layer itself. So just do undo for that, and instead of just dumping the paint bucket in it, choose select all, and then to fill this with the foreground color, press alt backspace on the PC, option delete on the Mac, and that avoids the problems with the corners. And now we're just going to deselect this. Now all I'm going to do is to create a pattern. So I'm going to start by choosing the pen tool, and I'm just going to draw a shape. So I'm just going to play around with this a little bit. Now, I'm not going to spend too much time doing it, because what's important for you is to just see how it's all done, not actually sit here watching me draw shapes. So I'm going to go to the direct selection tool and just make sure that this shape is all constrained within this area, because for me that's going to work better. I have a slight problem here. Okay, now that I've got my shape, I've got it filled with the same color as the foreground color. That's not really what I want, so I'm going to choose the Path Selection tool, and then let's go and fill it with a different color. So let's try something like this sort of orangey pink, and now I'm going to add a stroke to it. So I'll select a, probably a blue stroke for argument's sake, and let's make it a dotted stroke. So I'm going to choose more options. I'm going to do a dashed line with a 0 and 1, and I'm going to make the corners round, and I'm going to put them on the center of this line. Now I want this to be a little bit larger, so I'll go into this 6-point size, and I'm just going to wind that up a little bit so that we can see it a bit more clearly. And having done that, I might add another layer with another couple of little circles or something in it, just something that is visually interesting that we can play with here. So I've got a circle. It's on a new layer. I'm going to choose another color. And I'm just going to fill that circle with the color, Alt, Backspace, Option, Delete. And then I can duplicate this shape a couple of times, and then just move it into position. And again, all I'm looking for here is just something that we can see how the actual shape is going to work when we create a pattern from it. Okay, so let's call that good for now. I'm going to flatten all of this, so I'm just going to come here and merge all of these. And then I'm going to merge this with the layer below. And now our pattern is just this top corner. So with the background deselected, I'm just going to choose Edit and then Define Pattern. And we're just going to call this Triangle 3 and click OK. Now this is not an extremely inspiring pattern by any means, but let's see what happens when we go to use it, because how to use it is really what we're here for. Going to choose File and then New, and I'm going to create a 3000 by 3000 pixel image. Again, this tool works best not on the background layer, so I'm going to add a new empty layer to the image. And to create the pattern, we're now going to choose File and then scripts, and we're going to run this specify wallpaper using several patterns. And this will launch that script. You may well have to wait a few minutes before that actually launches. Now, here is the dialogue that you're faced with, and this is a critical selection you're going to make. Now, this is explained a little bit in the notes, but the problem is that the notes actually aren't very intelligible. So if we try and open them, it's very difficult to see exactly what they're all about. So let's just go to, I'm going to go to my downloads because that's where they are. And they're going to be in this partial plane symmetry file. And here's the problem is that you're seeing a lot of stuff appear here in the text, but it doesn't really make sense. It doesn't make much sense at all. So while you need this file for some of the details, for example, you can learn a little bit about what it's based on and you can see how to install it, you'll actually find that my installation will probably work a bit better than the one that's suggested here. And I'm stepping you through this early part of creating your pattern. So what you really want, I think what will be of more help to you is this website, and it is my website. There is a tool in Illustrator called Mad Pattern, and I've been using that for a while. And the Mad Pattern templates are based on the same template or pattern creating tool as this particular script is as well. So I'm going to give you this website in the description, but you'll see here that these are the patterns, so that we've got P1 here and this is P1. There's one for P2 here, and again in my notes here, here's the pattern for P2 and P3 and P3M1. Now, not all of them are identical, but there should be enough here that will get you started. The critical thing here is because we were working with a 45-45-90 triangle for creating our pattern, the pattern templates that we need to use, this sort of symmetry, needs to be one that uses a 45-45-90 triangle. So we could use P4G. You can see that P4G has this triangle in it, and so too does P4M. That's using that same triangle. So you want to find a pattern here that uses a triangle the same as you have created. PGG does as well. So if any of these letter combinations are available in this list, you can use them. So just use this to get a reference point. So I'm going to go and see if any of these are available. So I'm thinking PGG, and here it is. PGG is available. So if we have a look at PGG here, this is going to be the kind of rotation we're going to get with our pattern. Quite interesting. So I'm going to choose PGG, and I'm going to just use one pattern because we just have created one pattern. So I'll select that. Now, from this list here, I could choose the pattern, but it's going to be a whole lot easier if I choose See Pattern Pictures. So I'm going to come in here and I'm just going to select the very last pattern, which is the one I just created, and click OK. Ignore everything else. So this is the pattern now created in our pattern maker. Now I'm far from happy with that, so let's just turn that off. Let's go and create another pattern again using one of these patterns. So let's have a look and see if we can find something a bit nicer. I'm thinking P4M. Or P4G, let's see what they look like. So again, let's run that script, File, Scripts, Specify Wallpaper. And now what I'm looking for is one of those patterns. Let's see if P4G is here. Here it is, P4G. So we could use that. I'm going to use one pattern. Everything else is okay, so I'm going to choose to see my patterned pictures, click my pattern, and click OK. And here is the pattern. Now it's worked out a whole lot better with P4G. So let's go and have a look. One of the others that we could use for it is, let's see, we could try P4M. So let's turn that off and see what we get with P4M. Here's P4M, one pattern. Let's go and grab our pattern piece. And here that is. So this is one of the patterns we've been able to create. Here's another one. And then the one that I didn't like particularly, this one here. But there are some interesting pattern designs that you can create using this tool. What you'll want to do is to go and first of all identify the kind of pattern you want to create. This one uses a different shaped triangle again, and you'll want to identify the triangle in the template so you can use it. These use square templates, so you'd be using a square template. These here use a sort of diamond shape template, so you would want to use the diamond shape template to create your initial pattern for these. So using this set of images for the MAD pattern template images, you should be able to identify what sort of pattern base is used for each of these different symmetries so that you can then apply the correct symmetry to the pattern that you've designed. This is a really sophisticated tool. I've drawn a really pretty awful pattern here, and yet we've got some really interesting results from it. So we have actually been able to salvage something that didn't look particularly good and turn it into something a little bit different. Once you've got your pattern, you can of course just use your regular Photoshop tools to do something with it. For example, you can add a hue and saturation adjustment layer to the image. And you can then change the hue of the layer that you're working on. So this is the pattern hue. And so we can get some interesting color effects by just selecting a different hue. You can also apply a, for example, curves adjustment layer so that you can brighten or darken the areas of the image. So we could darken the reds, lighten the other colors, or go in reverse. And you can even drag the curve into all sorts of shapes that you typically wouldn't do with photographs, because this is a color curve and it's a pattern. So it's a whole lot more robust, for example, than a photograph would be. If you did this to a photograph, you get some sort of a cross-process effect. If you do it to a pattern, you're just getting some interesting effects. Now, if you create your patterns as transparent, you would be able to put a gradient underneath them. So that's another option that you have here. But there is some of the advanced scripting features available for patterns in Photoshop, this time using a downloaded script that creates some of these really, really sophisticated patterns for you. I'm Helen Bradley. Thank you for joining me for this video tutorial. Look out for more tutorials on this YouTube channel and subscribe to the channel for more tips, tricks, and tutorials on Photoshop, Illustrator, Lightroom, and a whole lot more.